Thank you for coming to our fourth annual Prado Benefit Concert. For those of you who have been here before, you know how fun of an evening this is and how much fun the kids have had today preparing their music and sharing with each other and getting to make new friends. This has been a great day and we're glad to have you here to share in it with us. This is the fourth annual and we get the kids to come for the whole day and they sing songs for each other and they get to work with our guest clinician, Dr. Clayton Parr. And so he gets to hear all of their pieces and let them know what else they could be working on, and then they get to perform them tonight. So as Penfield High School Chorale comes on the stage, we'll remind you to turn off all cell phones, or at least turn off the ringers. We would love if you would take pictures and use the hashtag Prado2017. That's what the kids have been sharing all day. The chorale is going to be singing a song called To Believe, arranged by Heather Sorensen, and it talks about peace in the world and hoping for stability and prosperity for everyone, which is a great theme for the Prado Benefit Concert. This benefits the Prado Community Center in Bogota, Colombia, where the children that it serves live in pretty destitute conditions. So the money that we're raising here is going to support these kids to help buy school supplies and uniforms and to give them a shot at a better life. So the Penfield High School Chorale is going to start with To Believe. Thank you.
Thank you.
Next, we're going to have the Harper Creek High School Honors Choir. They're going to be singing Sing Me to Heaven. It's a pretty popular poem that's been set to a lot of different tunes, and it's a poem about loneliness and reaching out to loved ones. Probably the most famous part of the text is, "If you would comfort me, sing me a lullaby. If you would win my heart, sing me a love song. If you would mourn me and bring me to God, sing me a requiem. Sing me to heaven." And let's welcome Harper Creek High School's Honor Choir. So Clayton is going to come and conduct them. And if Ian was here, he would definitely want me to tell you that the Battle Creek Girls Chorus is an organization that takes singers from third grade all the way through 12th grade. There's also the Companion Boy Choir. So these choirs that are at the Music Center, they offer a great chance for singers to learn more repertoire, to meet singers from other schools, and to actually have the opportunity to travel as well. So if you're interested, please check out the Music Center's webpage to see more information about the Boy Choir and the Girls Chorus. So please welcome Amabile, singing Carrick Fergus, and directed by Clayton Hart.
Thank you. Hi, my name is Sarah Cleland. My husband and I help with this, organize this event, and we work with the kids in Colombia that you guys are helping to support tonight. And I just want to say thank you for coming. Thank you to Harper Creek for letting us host this amazing event in this beautiful auditorium. Tonight, for the first time at a Prado concert, we have a guest from Colombia. This is Karen Rodriguez, and she is one of the kids that has grown up in the Prado Community Center over the years. She came to us quite a while ago, her and her three siblings. And Karen is a recycler, and she'll explain some of this, and you'll see it in the video in just a moment. But recycling basically means that you pick up trash on the side of the road for extremely long hours for the day and make maybe $10 in a day to feed your family. So Karen comes from a family of six. She has spent many years recycling in the early hours, 4 a.m. to 6 a.m. before she goes to school, and then attending school and then recycling again afterwards. We're super proud of her because she just last year graduated from high school. She was the first in her family. And that is thanks to this event and the jewelry that is sold. Karen's made quite a bit of that jewelry that you've purchased over the years. And she also graduated top of her class and is in college. Now she got a scholarship to study to be a teacher. So we're incredibly proud. To share with you tonight the difference that you guys have made in her life. She's extremely nervous. She has studied English for many years, but of course to walk into a foreign country and try to speak in their language is a little terrifying. So we are going to have the words up on the screen just to make sure you don't miss any of this. She wrote the speech herself, and we're super happy to have her here.
Good evening. It's a pleasure to be here with you tonight. And I want to thank you for being here tonight. My name is Karen Rodriguez, and I am from Colombia. I am part of the beautiful family of Project Hope, a family full of different children with different ages, colors, sizes, but also you. People from different places that they bring me now without knowing us are helping to make a positive impact in our lives. In Colombia, children of recyclers are often invisible to society. For most of us, our own aspiration is to continue with the same work that our parents do. Without Colombia, we are not treated with dignity, the world is not valued, and we are not paid well. Recycling in Colombia meant having to go into the streets to look for trash material that we come to sell, because we were in the streets, we face some dangers. Over the years, Project Hope has given us hope for our future. We have felt love and respect by each of you who help us. Many of us now have the possibility to study, to think about a future that is different from and better than our parents. Having the opportunity to study from us is a privilege, but although there is a free education in Colombia, the reality is that many times we lose the opportunity because we cannot afford the wings materials or uniforms. Project Hope gives us the opportunity not only of school, but also to able to perform the areas in which we need help. Today, I want to tell you that I am the first group of Project Hope Zone. The last year, I was made able to protect with support of all of you. Thank you very much for everyone for what you have done for me and for the support you give other children in Prado. To help us as we make our future different. Thank you.
Thank thank you to Karen for making that speech. That was just beautiful, and she was so nervous, and she did such a great job. Let's give her another round of applause. Next up, we're going to have Steve Bowen, the director of the Penfield High School Choirs. He's going to be singing Make Them Hear You from Ragtime by Stephen Flaherty. And he's accompanied by the wonderful Emily Buchma, who is the accompanist for the Penfield Choir. So let's welcome him.
We did talk to them about concert etiquette before we brought them out. Pal and Romine, I'll see you after the concert. Yeah, we know their voices. Go out and tell our story. Let it echo far and wide. Make them hear you, make them hear you. How justice was our battle and how justice was denied. Make them hear you, make them hear you. And say to those who blame us for the way we chose to fight, that sometimes there are battles that are more than black or white. And I could not put down my sword when justice was my right. Make them hear you, make them hear you. Tell the story to your daughters and your sons. Make them hear you, make them hear you. And tell them in our struggle we were not the only ones. Make them hear you, make them hear you. Teach every child to raise his voice, and then my brothers, then will justice be demanded by 10 million righteous men. Make them hear you.
Is the Harper Creek High School treble choir singing I Loved You by Jay Rouse.
I love you, and perhaps I love you.
next up is the Penfield High School Women's Choir. They're singing Stand in the Light, arranged by Roger Emerson. And this one is, you can tell at the rehearsals today that the kids really enjoy singing this one. It's a kind of empowering and encouraging sort of text. It talks about being true to yourself and the benefits of that, but also the courage that it takes to be yourself. And the kids really seem to take this message to heart. So let's welcome the Penfield High School Women's Choir, directed by Steve Bowen. Some of us adults thought, why should the kids have all the fun? So we wanted to do a song for you guys. So it's going to be me and Clayton and Steve and Greg We're going to sing a song for you guys. It's called Blackbird. Four of us just put this together today, and I think it sounds pretty great. So please welcome us. School's Chamber Choir. They're going to be singing Zion's Walls by Aaron Copland. This is a revivalist song, so one that you might imagine a big tent revival trying to drum up support for the Lord. And so this is a great kind of stomping song. It's great to watch them rehearse this earlier today. While they're coming up, I wanted to, I know Sarah mentioned it earlier, but thank you so much to Harper Creek High School for hosting this event for the third year in a row. Let's give them all a great round of applause. They've been such gracious hosts for us, which is fortunate because they're the biggest auditorium in the city, so thank you. Thank you for making this possible, for letting all of the great things that you saw in the video happen today, all of the amazing rehearsing, the companionship of getting to meet more singers, more. If you're in choir, if you've been in choir, you know what a choir nerd feels like. And so it's great to see those fellow choir nerds from the other school districts. And getting to learn the repertoire that they're singing, getting to hear the choirs and all the great work that they've been doing all fall. And then of course getting to learn from our guest clinician every year. It's a really great opportunity for everyone. And we're grateful to Harper Creek and to Sarah and Jason and for all of you for helping make this possible. So thank you for all of your support. Let's welcome Lakeview High School.
I can have the directors come up to the front, Greg and Steve and Eric, for just a moment. So this is the fourth year, and these guys are amazing. We obviously would not be able to do this without their help and their participation, and it's kind of crazy trying to get everybody's schedules together, and they're super patient. And I usually only thank them with Panera for lunch. But today, I want to give them something else. So, we have these plaques for each school. It says thank you. This one says thank you, Harper Creek, but you each get your own. Thank you. It says thank you to each school for helping us to raise over $15,000 for the Prado Community Center. And the artwork is pretty cool. It's street art in Colombia. If you go downtown in Bogota, you can get a lot of street art. And this was made from shoe polish from a guy that was just sitting out in the street trying to make some extra money. And some awesome friends I have turned it into an awesome plaque for the director. So thank you guys.
All right, so now the organized chaos begins. We're going to start bringing up all of the women's choirs from all three schools. While they're coming up as efficiently as they can, I would like to tell you about our guest clinician tonight. His name is Dr. Clayton Parr. You've already seen him on stage a couple times. He is the director of choral activities at Albion College, conductor of the Battle Creek Community Chorus, and the founder and director of Alioni, a choir that specializes in folk music from the Republic of Georgia, and founder and director of MEAM, the Michigan Educators Male Ensemble. So he's a pretty busy guy, so we're really thankful to have him here. He's a very sought-after clinician and adjudicator, and has been doing clinics across the state, across the region, and we're really happy to have him here. The piece that he chose for the women's groups is a piece called Te Quiero, which means I love you or I adore you. But it's a little bit different than your typical love song. It's about the love that you feel for your comrades in arms, for people that you struggle to struggle with to fight for a greater cause. And the cause that they're talking about in this song is justice for all. It's standing up for what's right, and it's a great kind of song to bring everybody together. So we have two soloists for this song. We're going to have Alana Dyer from Penfield, and Joan Welk from Harper Creek. Please welcome Dr. Clayton Parr and the women's choruses from Penfield, Harper Creek, and Lakeview.
Take care as well. few more things here while we're making this stage change, which takes a little while. We have over 200 students here, and we have to get some folks off stage and back on. When I was asked to do this by Sarah to help support the Prado Community Center, I wanted to bring something from the South American continent to you in the selections for the concert tonight. This first piece that you've heard has a refrain where it's a love song, but what she is saying is that when we're together, when we're working for something that's more important than, that's larger than us, we are much more than two. Somos mucho más que dos, is the term. And so you'll see these students walking around all day with these t-shirts that say sing and make a difference. And it's been a real inspiration to be around that and to live that in terms of making a difference, not only in raising money for a worthy cause, which I think a lot of us can get behind, but if we do it right, we will make differences in more ways than just financial. That the very presence of these young people singing together on stage and finding ways to communicate and make a difference in your life and then also in their own has a power that again is beyond any one of us can do individually. And so I want to thank you for supporting that in them, that in the midst of a time that sometimes seems to be about me, that you've supported these students in working together towards something that's going to make a difference for all of us. So thank you for that. While the SATB choir and the percussion is coming on, maybe one more thing. I would like to extend a personal thank you for this event and this happening to someone who is normally not in the spotlight, but someone without whom this event surely would not be taking place. And so I'd like to offer my thanks to Sarah Cleland. Sarah, where are you? Up there in the way. And probably as Sarah can tell you, because she's been to the Prado Community Center, she's been to Colombia, that when we work and when we volunteer and when we offer to make a difference in other people's lives, sometimes that when we have an idea about how that's going to go, how it's going to work when we go somewhere and volunteer and help people who need help. And often what you will find if you step out of your own comfort zone, whether it's through the Prado Community Center or another one of the thousands of ways that are out there in our lives now for you to come out and make a difference, one of the things that you will find is that you may well change the world, you may well help these people and make a difference in their lives, but one of the things that will happen that you may not expect is that your own life will be transformed. So think about that the next time someone offers an opportunity to step out of the comfort zone. I think I've covered enough so that everybody's on stage. So we just did a piece from Argentina. This final piece is from Brazil, Xangô, the evocation of the spirits. And this represents the Afro-Brazilian tradition from Northeast Brazil. I'd like to thank you all for coming. It's been a pleasure to work with these students today, and I'd like to thank their directors as well. You saw that with the three of them up here, that we have leaders, we have champions in this community. We have champions for our students, for our young people, and also people who care about the community. And so the Battle Creek area is very fortunate to have these three gentlemen here. Aren't they, Clark? So here we go, Chango.
Have a great night.